So here we are back at Sky Fitness. This week we're going to catch up with Ryan and Daniel, who've competed before. They're also in the athletic section. Daniel in the over 40s and Ryan just in the open. So I have a quick chat to them, see how they're getting on. And we're going to be following them right through, right up until competition day in September. So we'll get into that now. Cheers.
2014 was in the Christchurch Classic. I just had a crack at it. I was getting in good shape. Had a good diet plan going on and all that, so I thought I'd follow it right through. Do a stage just to say I've done one before. Jumped on stage, done quite well, so I thought, oh yeah. Gave me that little bug I wanted to sort of compete for the South Islands, and I did that also. And then that was a year ago now, so I've done a couple of three shows since then as well, so been quite good.
What sort of placings have you had?
I've had various places three times. One of those times was overall. I've done first places about four times now.
Nice. So you're obviously looking to compete again this year?
Yeah.
And what are your goals, you know, going forward for this year?
Just to even out and get the body proportion quite good. So like I'm quite lean up top. My downfall is my legs, so I'm trying to do a lot more reps down there. So I've been not focusing too much on the top half, just sort of smashing the bottom half, working on the hamstrings and the glutes, all that sort of stuff, just to make everything look all good. And then when show day's ready, hopefully they're looking in better shape by then. Well, at the moment, I'm sort of, just because I've had a couple of shows just recently, I'm sort of trying to smash back as much food as I can. I'm still clean eating, just a lot of everything, so I haven't really put everything down to a fine art yet, so I'm just tweaking up little things to see what works best, and then I'll follow it right through until the next show and then see what happens then, see what was different from the last show to this show. Yeah, dieting's very hard, you got to get yourself, got to get your mindset in the right spot for that, but yeah, once you've done it once or twice, you sort of can change into it quite easily, and it's not too much of a shock, and you find it a lot easier the more times you do it. Still very hard, but and saying that's what you aim for.
Yeah. And what have you found like sort of the most rewarding out of the whole thing?
Watching everyone do well. Not like, just watching the effort that everyone else puts into it, more the group effort that goes on in between hand, helping that person do their game, helping this person do their game. And then at the same time watching your own gains, and it's just not so much watching on how much you gain, it's how much the whole group gains. Win or lose, it's still pretty fun by the end of it. Like, we all feel like shit by the end of it, but, yeah. You know, it's a good thing we all made it to that spot. We're all up on the stage, we all did it together. Won a big game. Yeah. Shane's very good at what he does. He makes everyone feel like they're a part of the family, so everyone feels welcome, everyone's comfortable, everybody's willing to speak. You know, sometimes you feel a bit shy and you won't speak what you want to, but around here everyone's willing to say probably too much. So showing everyone love, getting love back, so yeah.
Nice.
It's been quite good. Power tech rules for that. Yeah.
And you did the pairs as well with Shannon. How was that, something different? Like
It was trying to get on the same level to start off with. It was hard, but Shannon was a very good person, very easy going, very willing to try the new things. I actually learned a bit from it too. It was my first time doing a pairs routine. It was her first time. It was actually her first time competing in general. So it was a bit of a learning curve for both of us. But yeah, once we found we could rely on each other properly, everything else fell into place, just like that. Everything worked out real well. We've done quite well in that. We finished first. I'd like to have another crack at that one day. Because, little things that you try and work on from the last time, when you watch back on yourself and you think, oh yeah, I could change that up for the next time, change this up for the next time, or maybe not so fast into this movement, and just, you know, pick up on your little flaws and you'll just want to try and tweak up for the next time they do it. So yeah, I'd like to have another crack at that one day, just to say that, you know, did it again.
Nice. That's probably, I don't know, is there anything else?
Yes, much love, Sky Fitness.
Yep.
I'm Danny Pride, joined up with the team at Sky, and in particular Shane Waldron wrote me a diet plan a couple of years ago. So first year was 2014. I got into it basically, well, for me, I wanted to get big. I've always had, I think, manorexia. I wanted to get some size, and Shane said, oh, you'd be a good candidate to get on stage and give it a go. So, yeah, stuck to his diet plan and got second place in the South Island NABBA show in 2014. Yeah, so last time I was 38, so I was short athletic. This time around I'll be 40 plus, so in with the older guys, more experienced. And hopefully I can put some size on and show them up. To be honest, I didn't really struggle with the diet. I enjoyed the food, and at the start I sort of struggled to eat. It seemed like a lot of food at the start. As I got through it, I just stuck to it, and it was probably the last week I felt a bit tired, a little bit crampy. My wife might say something else. She might say I was like that the whole way through, but it was a good experience, and I didn't find it too hard. I enjoyed the experience, and getting on stage was great. It's a big thing to get on stage, and I didn't focus too much on that. And looking back, I should have thought more about the stage presence. I was probably scared of being on stage, so I didn't want to focus on the big day, more about doing my diet and my training in preparation for the big day. So next time around, I'm going to probably put more emphasis on the posing, trying to get that right, because that's probably the bit that let me down at the end of the day, if I can get the posing right. There's a lot of work that needs to go into that, and if I can master that, I might do it right.
And what's the sort of diet and training and regime like at the moment?
Bulking, so eat. And pretty much train as much as I can. Just do as much as I can whenever I can.
So yeah.
It's funny, I never saw myself as being a bodybuilder. I remember going to town and one night this dude said, shit man, you've got about 4 t-shirts on, you're trying to look big. And I said, yeah, 4 t-shirts and 2 pair of jeans. And like I did, I used to wear heaps of clothes to try and look like I was bigger. So it's probably been a thing that a chip on my shoulder I need to get off and try and achieve that size thing. I think if I can achieve that, then I'll feel better on myself. And the team at PowerTech are great. Good guys to train with. Shane writes awesome diets and he's really encouraging. So looking forward to the next year.
Yeah, so now's the time to really start picking up the pace and putting in the yards over the summer, getting really aggressive with the workouts and really focusing on the year ahead. We've got a show that sort of creeps up pretty quickly in Christchurch in May, the Grand Prix, so that's always a pretty awesome show to do and be a part of. Then there's August that rolls around pretty quickly after that as well. So that's a smaller one, a really good one for the first time competitors to shoot up and do, just to get a feel for the stage leading into the big one here in September. So it's just really getting stuck in and doing as much as you can before the cutting really starts. That's when you really start feeling flat and the energy levels drop pretty quickly. So saying that though, we're at the perfect position and place here with the PowerTech team. There's always somebody that's going to be up there training, so it's like a big family. There's always going to be someone to give you a spot or push you through those tough times when you need it. It's pretty good. You're never on your own anyway, so it's just getting to the gym. Sometimes it can be the hard part, but once you hear it all, it's always good times. Breathing apparatus here that I've got. So these things normally really good for high intensive sports and stuff like that, rugby players, cage fighters, stuff like that, where you're going to have really short hard bursts of energy. So just help try and regulate breathing and stuff like that. But I want to try it out while we're doing some big exercise. Do you want to jump in there?
Crash this dummy.
So
it's a moustache, eh?
Just don't get a... Oh. My darling, you.
Also, it'll be interesting to see how this works. Bittersweet.
That is all I'm taking with me. So
Yeah. It's like, what the hell am I doing?
Now it's coming back to me.
Yeah.
Fucking leg day with Shane.